Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Welcome to the new year. This is our first podcast of 2008. I want to take a look this week at how to get data from the web. And the first step today is just simply copying and pasting the data from the web. Tomorrow, we're then going to take a look at how to take that data that's been pasted and get the links out of it. So I'm going to start here at Mr. Excel. I'm going to go to the left-hand nav and use Learn Excel Resources and then Articles. This is a great page that has about 585 different articles on it. Basically, not just articles from my site, but articles from JWalk and Chip Pearson and Tech TV. So I'm going to just select a section of this web page here, grab the text, and I'll use Control C to copy, and then switch back to Excel and cell A1, hit Control V to paste. All right, now the first really annoying thing we have, and this happens with so many different websites, the websites try and be cute and add these little graphical icons in. Well, unfortunately, those icons usually get pasted into the data, and it's very annoying to go through one by one by one to select them and get rid of them all. So my trick is we're going to go to the drawing toolbar. If you don't have the drawing toolbar shown, you want to go to View Toolbars Drawing, and it appears at the bottom of the screen. Let's look down here at the bottom. In the drawing toolbar, the second icon is a white arrow. It's called Select Objects. Now we turn on Select Objects, and then basically we're going to draw a rectangle around all of those icons. And what it does is it selects all of the icons at once. Now I can just simply hit the Delete key, and everything is good. Now, if you happen to get interrupted right now and leave the computer and then come back 5 minutes from now, you're going to be completely freaked out because nothing you do in Excel will work. For example, if I try and choose cell E2, it doesn't work. If I try and right-click on this hyperlink, it doesn't work. Why? Because I'm still in Select Objects mode. I have to go back down to that white arrow and uncheck it to get back to the regular mode where I can continue to use Excel. So it's a very cool tool, although watch out because if you inadvertently leave it on, nothing will work in Excel. All right, so there we go. We have a whole series of links. Now, tomorrow, I'm going to take a look at how we can take that data and actually extract the links from each cell and put it in a new column. Thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.